Jnana-timirandasya Jnananjana-shalakaya Chaksur-militam yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namam Vishnupadaya Krishna-pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the Madhya Lila of Lord Chaitanya's pastimes, and we were hearing how Lord Chaitanya was dancing at the Rath Yatra festival of Lord Jagannath. And we were hearing how the deities of Lord Jagannath and Lord Balaram would sometimes arrange to stop their cars so that they could watch Lord Chaitanya dancing. At one point, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing and wandering through the around in front of the chariot of Lord Jagannath when he fell down, and it happened that he fell down in front of Maharaj Prataparudra. So the king, seeing Lord Chaitanya falling down on the ground, he immediately bent down and helped to pick him up with great respect.
所以说呢，当国王看到主这样摔倒下来的时候呢，他立刻就满怀着敬意，弯下身子要接住主，让他别摔着。But
when Lord Chaitanya saw the king, he was not so happy.
但是，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 看到王国王的时候呢，他不是特开心。
And Lord Chaitanya condemned himself. He was saying, oh, it's such a shame. I have touched a person who is interested in mundane affairs. So at that time, other devotees like Lord Nityananda and Govinda, his servant, they were not so near and they were not able to take care of Lord Chaitanya. Now, Lord Chaitanya was already pleased to see the behavior of the king, because he saw the king sweep for the Lord Jagannath.
But
So for a king to take a brush and to start to sweep the road as a service for the deity, it shows a lot of humility. Lord Chaitanya could understand the king was really a good devotee, and he actually desired to meet the, to see the king.
所以说呢, 主柴丹娘妈妈不, 她其实能明白这位国王是一位非常伟大的奉献者, 而且呢, 她其实很有愿望, 想要见这位国王。
But Lord Chaitanya has to show, he has to show an example to all the other devotees, and he doesn't want to show too much affection for a king.
但是呢, 主柴丹娘妈妈不呢, 她就必须要为其他的奉献者树立一个榜样, 然后呢, 要让大家看到, 她其实对国王是没有那么多的情感的。
He wanted to warn all of his followers. So when Lord Chaitanya, when he externally showed his anger, it was to teach his followers. But actually, in actual fact, Lord Chaitanya had great respect for the king, and he didn't have any anger towards him.
但事实上呢, 主柴丹娘妈妈布对国王是十分的尊重的, 他其实并没有对他生气。
But it's very dangerous for a person to have intimate relationships with non-devotees.
但是呢, 和非奉献者有很亲密的联谊，这是很危险的。
So anybody who really wants to go back to Godhead, they have to be very careful who they associate with.
所以呢，任何一个想要回归守时的人，他都要非常的小心他联谊的对象。
So the king, oh Lord Chaitanya rather, Lord Chaitanya was actually satisfied with the humble behavior of the king.
所以说呢, 嗯，Sri Chaitanya妈妈布呢, 他其实是非常的满意于国王他所展现出来的谦卑的姿态的。
And when he fell down, at that time Lord Chaitanya, actually he allowed the king to touch him.
所以说呢, 当Sri Chaitanya妈妈布摔倒在地的时候, 他其实允许了国王碰他。
But he wanted to warn his associates, and so he showed a little anger towards the king.
但是呢,他又想要警告他的追随者,他的同僚们,所以说呢,他又展现出他对国王的愤怒。
So when Lord Chaitanya showed a little anger, then the king became frightened.
所以当主柴丹娘妈妈布他显现有点生气的时候呢,这国王就变得很害怕。
But the Bhattacharya was there beside the king, and he told the king, "Don't worry, he's actually happy with you. But he just wants to teach his devotees how to behave."
但是呢, Bhattacharya 刚好就站在国王的面前，所以呢，他就安慰国王说呢，你别害怕，别担心。其实呢，主对你是很满意的，但是呢，他要以这样的方式来教导他的追随者们应该如何恰当的行事。
When you use the word, is that mean God or does that mean Lord or what?
Lord.
It can mean Lord, is it? Okay.
Then yeah. It only means a master. Yeah, actually it's more like a master.
Oh, okay. That's all right, yeah. So it's different from God, right?
Yeah, God is like Shen.
But it's the same word, is it?
Well, in the different contexts, they are using different ways, and for people who know the context, they also get a different understanding of it.
Okay.
Sometimes they realize it's a master, as a lord, and sometimes they think that is a god. But okay. This is really based on the context.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so sometimes devotees, it appears like they're interested in money, but they're actually often humble and surrender to Krishna.
那有的时候呢，人们他们显现出来好像他是对钱很感兴趣，但其实呢，他是非常的谦卑的，而且呢，他是臣服于 Krishna 的。
So we have to be very careful when we judge people.
所以说呢，当我们在评判一个人的时候，我们要非常的小心。
The general principle is that no devotee should intimately mix with non-devotees who are interested in money.
但是呢，就是这个总体的原则，就是任何一个奉献者，他都不应该去和对钱非常感兴趣的非奉献者联谊，有紧密的联谊。
Of course, we have to associate with people, but don't associate intimately. That's the point.
但是呢，我们也必须得去跟别人交往。可是呢，我们在和别人交往的时候呢，就不要特别的亲密。
So the Bhattacharya said to the king, he said, I'm going to tell the king, as soon as I get a chance, I'm going to tell the king and we'll make arrangements for you to come and meet him.
Tell the king.
Tell him. I'm going to inform him that you're, he'll tell the king, Bhattacharya is speaking to the king. He said, just be patient. He said, when I get time, then I will meet with Lord Chaitanya and we will arrange for you to come and meet with him.
然后呢 Bhattacharya 就对国王说呢，就安慰他说，你别担心，别着急，我呢只要一有机会，我就会见主 Chaitanya， 然后呢我会请他来见你的，与你相见的。
So Lord Chaitanya, after the king picked him up, then Lord Chaitanya circumambulated the chariot of Lord Jagannath.
那然后呢，主 Chaitanya 马哈布，他就绕拜了 Jagannath 的弹车。
And then he began to push the chariot, but he began to push it with his head.
然后呢，他就开始推 Jagannath 所坐的这个弹车，他是用他的头去推的。
And as soon as he pushed the car, it immediately began to move, and it made a rattling noise.
而且呢，就是当他这么一推的时候呢，这车立刻就开始动了，而且呢，开始发出了这个推动的声音。
And all the people began to chant, Hari Hari.
所有的人看这车动了以后呢，就立刻大声的呼唤起来 ，Hari Hari.
So Lord Chaitanya brought his devotees in front of the chariot, in front of the chariot of Lord Balaram and Lord and Subhadra Maharani.
然后呢，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 又把他所有的这些奉献者们又给带到了主 Balaram 和Subhadra Maharani 的弹车前。
And then Lord Chaitanya began to dance in front of them.
然后主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢又开始在他们面前跳舞。
And then, after Lord Chaitanya finished dancing in front of Lord Balaram and Subhadra Maharani, then Lord Chaitanya came back to Lord Jagannath's car.
然后，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在主 Balaram 和 Subhadra Maharani 的弹车前跳完舞之后呢，他又回到了主 Jagannath 的弹车前面。
And then he began to dance again.
然后呢，他又开始跳起来。
And then they came to this place where they came to a place, the name is Balagandhi. And at that place, many devotees came with offerings for the deities.
然后呢，他们就来到了一个叫巴拉甘迪的地方。那么在这个地方呢，就很多奉献者都走上前来向神像献上他们的贡品。
There was a neighborhood of many brahmanas.
那地方呢就是那个地区呢是有很多的婆罗门。
And there were many coconut trees there.
而且那儿呢有很多的椰子树。
And there was a nice flower garland, a garden.
有很美的开满了鲜花的花园。
And the garden was just like those in Vrindavan.
那些花园就像在文达文的花园是一样的。
So Lord Chaitanya and all the devotees were dancing in front of Lord Jagannath, and the car stopped to and Lord Jagannath was watching the dancing.
当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和所有的这些奉献者们在主 Jagannath 的面前跳舞的时候呢，主 Jagannath 又把他的车又停了下来，然后呢，来观赏着所有的这些奉献者们跳舞。
So every year when they would come to this place, all the brahmanas' wives would come out and they would bring offerings for the deities.
就每年弹车节的时候，当弹车到这儿的时候呢，所有的这些婆罗门们的妻子们全部都会带着他们各自的献给神像的贡品来到这里。
And Lord Jagannath would taste all of the different offerings they brought.
而主迦那呢，他就会品尝他们所带来的所有的贡品。
And there were all kinds of devotees. Some of the devotees were neophyte and some were more advanced. But they all offered their best food to Lord Jagannath.
他们是各种各样的奉献者，有些奉献者呢是非常的高级的，还有一些奉献者呢是一些新的奉献者。但是他们全都竭尽全力地把他们准备的最好的这个贡品献给了主 Jagannath。
And then there were the devotees like the king with his queens.
然后还有一些奉献者，比如说像是国王啊，带着他们的妻子、皇后。
And then he had all his ministers and his friends.
还有就是大臣们以及他们的朋友们。
And all kinds of different people who were resident in Jagannath Puri. Some were big important people, and some were not very important people.
所以呢，这些全部都是居住在 Jagannath Puri 的居民们，有些呢是非常地位显赫的人们，还有一些呢，就是平民的平常的老百姓。
There were many visitors who had come to attend the Rath Yatra. They'd come from different places, far away from like foreign areas.
还有呢，就是从很远的地方前到这里来的一些其他的那些地方的人们。不在加纳普瑞的人也前来参加这弹车节。
And they'd also prepared food and brought it to offer to Jagannath.
那他们呢也都准备了很多的食物来献给主 Jagannath.
So they were offering the food everywhere. There was food in front of the car, and behind it, and on the two sides, and even in the flower garden.
住的地方，有的时候呢是把这个就是这个食物是放在车子的后面的。
And they were making the offerings everywhere.
那所以说呢，他们就在所有的地方都会准备这个供奉。
So then a big crowd began to gather.
那这样一来呢，就有很多人都聚集过来了。
So then Lord Chaitanya stopped his dancing, and he went into a nearby garden.
那这样的话呢，就使得主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 停止了他的舞蹈，然后他就去到了附近的一个花园里。
So when Lord Chaitanya came in the garden, he lay flat down on the ground. He's very tired from dancing.
然后当他来到这个花园之后呢，他一下子就平躺在了花园的地上，因为他跳舞跳得很疲惫了。
His body was all covered in perspiration.
他浑身都出，他就是他大汗淋漓，浑身都是汗。
So he was enjoying the cool breeze in the garden and the fragrance, the nice smell coming from the flowers there.
所以呢，他在花园里面就享受着花园里面的轻轻的微风，以及在花园里面弥漫着的芬芳四溢的花香。
So all the devotees who'd been doing kirtan, they all came there to take rest.
当时在进行 kirtan 的所有的奉献者们呢，全部都来到了花园里面，在这里休息。
So this is how we describe the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya dancing in the Rath Yatra.
So this is what we describe Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the Rath Yatra dancing in the Rath Yatra.
It is said anybody who hears the description of the Rath Yatra festival will be able to go to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
就有这样一个说法，说任何一个聆听到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在弹车节上起舞的这些时光的人，都会去到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 那里。
And he will have firm faith in devotional service, and he will develop love of God.
而且呢，他还会有心坚意稳的奉对于奉爱服务的信心，以及呢，他会回到守神的身边。
All right, so that's end of chapter 13. We're going to go on to chapter 14 to hear about the performance of the Vrindavan pastimes.
那所以呢，我们现在就结束了第十三章的讲述。我们现在要聆听的是第十四章的讲述。这第十四章的题目呢，就是聆听Vrindavan的逍遥。
So we heard Lord Chaitanya was tired after dancing in the Rath Yatra, and he went into the garden and lay down.
那我们就听到说呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在弹车节上跳舞之后呢，就非常的疲惫，所以呢，他就到了旁边的一个花园里面躺下来休息。
So at that time, the king entered into the garden. And the,
在这会儿呢 ，sorry,
and the king had changed his dress. He'd put taken off the dress of the king.And he put on ordinary dress of a devotee.
那么这会儿呢，这位国王他就来到了这个花园里。他这会儿呢，已经脱下了他国王的装扮，而穿上了普通的奉献，就是奉献者的普通的衣服。
Now sometimes people criticize our devotees for changing the dress and not wearing the devotee dress.
那有的时候呢，奉献者就会受到这样的批评，说我们奉献者把我们的服装都给改变了，没有再穿奉献者应该穿的衣服。
And they say you're just trying to cheat people. You don't want them to know you're a devotee.
然后他们就说到呢，你们只是想骗别人，你们不想让大家知道你们是奉献者。
Especially, you know, when we go in the public for book distribution, if we have shaved heads and wear clothes like.Dhoti and so on, and then people may not talk to us, they may avoid us.
那就比如说当我们在公共场合派书的时候，如果我们要是把头发剃得光光的，而且还穿着奉献者的衣服的话，那人们也许可能就不会理我们，他们就不会这个，他们就会忽略我们。
And so some devotees find it more convenient for book distribution to wear ordinary dress.
所以呢，有些奉献者就发现，在派书的时候，如果要是穿便服的话呢，就会更加的方便。
So Prabhupada gave his approval for this.
那么这一点呢，舍尔巴巴实际上是给予了许可的。
He said the main thing is that you said don't dress in an untidy manner, but present yourself, be very smartly dressed, and look good, look proper, so that people will respect you.
舍尔巴巴说呢，就是不要把自己穿的是不干不净的那个样子，那呢要把自己给打扮的还是很精明、很能干，而且呢就是很整齐的样子，因为这样的话呢，人们就会尊重你。
So we see here in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya how the king also disguised himself.
那所以我们在这儿看到的呢，也是国王他把他自己给伪装了起来。
The Bhattacharya had told him, it will be easier for you to meet Lord Chaitanya if you're not dressed as a king.
The Bhattacharya 对国王说，如果你要是不装扮成国王的样子呢，那可能就更加的容易使主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 见你。
So the king changed his dress and he came in to meet Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，国王就更换了他自己的服装，然后进来要见拜见主 Chaitanya。
Now, of course, you get people like you know Buddhist monks. You know they never change their dress. They will always wear the monk dress.
那比如说像佛教的僧人，那他们其实永远都是穿着他们的僧袍的，他们是不会换衣服的。
So sometimes when people see When they see our devotees, they see us, sometimes they see us in devotee dress, and then another time they see us in karmi dress, ordinary clothes. So they become confused.
So, when people see us in devotee dress, they become confused. So, when people see us in devotee dress, they become confused. So, when people see us in devotee dress, they become confused. So, when people see us in devotee dress, they
become confused. They shouldn't be confused. They should understand that we justdo this sometimes we wear the ordinary dress just for preaching Krishna consciousness.
但实际上呢，他们是不应该表示困惑的。他们应该理解， 我们之所以有的时候会穿普通人的衣服的原因，就是为了在这样的装饰装束下更容易的传播 Krishna 知觉。
Now, particularly in Western countries, we don't have any problem to wear the devotee dress.
特别是在西方国家，当我们穿奉献者的衣服的时候呢，其实是没有太多问题的。
But some devotees, they don't like to go out into the public in the devotee dress, and they hide themselves.
但是呢，有的奉献者他就不喜欢穿着奉献者的衣服去到公众场合，他们会把自己给藏起来。
And even if they have to go to the shop and go to the market, they will change their dress and put on ordinary clothes.
那即便是他们要去商店、要去市场买东西的话呢，他们也会把衣服换了，换成普通的衣服。
But it's not, that's not really necessary. We can continue to wear the devotee dress.
但其实在西方其实是不必要换衣服的，可以穿着奉献者的衣服去做这些事情。
And Srila Prabhupada said that if people just simply see the devotees dressed in the devotee dress with their shaved heads and tilak on their foreheads and tosi mala around their neck, then it's purifying for ordinary people to see the devotees like that.
Srila Prabhupada 他说，就是看着奉献者的这一身装束，比如说头发是剃得光光的，然后前额上抹着这个提拉克，然后脖子上戴着图拉西的净珠，就是普通的人看到奉献者的这身装束，对于他们来说都是净化。Srila Prabhupada 怎么讲的？
Yeah, as soon as whenever they see the devotees, then they will be reminded of Krishna.
Because when they see the devotees, they immediately be reminded of Krishna.
But when we change the dress and put on ordinary dress, then we don't remind people of Krishna.
But when we change the dress and put on ordinary dress, then we don't remind people of Krishna. But when we change the dress and put on ordinary dress, then we don't remind people of
Krishna. However,If our purpose of changing the dress, if our purpose in changing the dress is to facilitate our preaching and for our service to Krishna, then it's all right.
但是我们换衣服的目的是为了让我们能够更好的为 Krishna 做服务，为了更好的能够传播 Krishna 知觉的话，那是没有问题的。
So the king was very humble and.He's coming in an ordinary dress, and he's very humble, and he comes before the devotees, and he takes permission from all of them. And then he came and touched the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以说呢，这位国王他穿着便装，他非常的谦卑的来到所有的奉献者面前，然后呢，从所有的奉献者这里得到了允许，然后他就允许他到主持参加马会的面前向水沙的马布顶礼，并且触碰他的莲花足。
So Lord Chaitanya was laying on a platform which was off the ground, and he was laying down there with his eyes closed. And at that time, the king came and began to massage his legs.
那这会儿水沙参加马布呢，他是睡在就是比地上比就比地面稍微高一点的这个台子上的，他躺在那儿，然后眼睛是闭着的，然后国王呢就来到他的面前，就开始为主持参加马哈布按摩他的双腿。
So when the king began to give massage to Lord Chaitanya, at that time he began to recite verses from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以呢，当国王开始在为主持参加马哈布按摩他的双腿的时候，他就开始诵读圣典普加瓦塔里面的诗节。
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had told him to recite from there's five chapters which are about the pastimes of Lord Krishna with the gopis. He said you can recite from that section.
因为在圣典普加瓦塔里面有五个章节讲的是。Sri Chaitanya, Sri Krishna 与 Gopi 们的消时光的话题的，然后 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢就跟国王说可以诵念这一部分的内容。
And the section which the king began to recite was the section which is the Gopi Gita, the song sung by the Gopis.
所以呢，他们国王他所念的这一部分呢是 Gopi Gita 的这一部分，也就是 Gopi 之歌。
Yeah, it's in the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and it's chapter number 31.
这是在圣典伯加瓦坛第十篇的第31章。
And there's only, it's not a big chapter, there's only 19 verses.
这一章呢, 不是有很多的世界的一个篇章, 里面只有19个世界。
And these are very beautiful verses, and they're written in a very beautiful poetic manner.
那这是非常美的诗节，所有的这些诗节呢，都是充满着诗情画意的。
And you get some devotees, they can sing, and when you hear it, it's so beautiful.
那有些奉献者呢，是会唱的，当他们在唱出来，然后我们在听的时候呢，就会感觉其中是多么的美妙。
Jayati te dikam janmana praja shayata indira shasvadatrahi daita drishyatam dikshutavaka twaidritasavas twambachinvate. Like that, that's the first verse of the Gopi Gita.
那么就像这样的，刚才Marge唱的这个呢，就是Gopi Gita之歌的第一个十节。
Wait, I have a recording. I'll look. Okay, I hope you like that. That's Indian people singing it very beautifully. So it's a song of the Gopis. The Gopis are searching for Krishna. They don't know where he's gone. Krishna had called them to come to the forest to dance Rasa Leela. But at a certain point, Krishna disappeared from them. So the gopis, they're in so much anxiety that where is Krishna? Where did he go?
所以说呢，Gopi们就处于极度的焦虑之中，他们就在想，Krishna到哪里去了？他到底去了哪里？
And they're worried about Krishna's soft lotus feet, because in Vrindavan there's many sharp stones and thorns on the ground, and they're worried that they'll be pricking Krishna's soft lotus feet.
因为他们非常为 Krishna的柔软的莲花足担忧，因为在 森林里面呢，有很多很硬的石子儿，还有很多的刺荆棘，所以呢，他们就会担心说这一刺呢，就会刺痛Sri Krishna的柔软的莲花足。
So the gopis are singing also. They're singing about how Lord Brahma was stupid, that he gave us eyes which blink and we cannot see Krishna, because of the blinking of our eyes, we lose the sight of Krishna.
然后呢，他们还在责备主Brahma的创造，责备主Brahma他创造了这个眼皮，以至于呢，就是我们必须要眨眼，这么一眨眼呢，就看不见Sri Krishna了。
So the king, he'd memorized all these verses, and he was singing them while he was massaging Lord Chaitanya.
所以国王呢，他是记住所有的这些诗节了，然后呢，当他在给Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 按摩的时候呢，他就在唱诵说这些诗节。
And when Lord Chaitanya heard these verses, he was so happy, because he knew exactly what was being sung, what was being said.
当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到所有这些诗歌被唱出来的时候呢，他非常的开心，因为他知道唱的都是什么。
So he said, "Go on reciting, go on reciting."
所以呢，他就说到。 请继续不断的念诵，不断的唱诵，不断的唱诵，不断的诵念。
So at a certain point, the king came to the ninth verse, verse number nine.
唱着唱着呢，国王就唱到了第九十节。
And the verse was, Tavakatam ritam tapta jivanam kavibiritam kaumasapaham shravanamangalam srimadatatam bhuvigrinantite puridajana. And when the king heard this, when Lord Chaitanya heard this, when he heard this Tavakatam ritam, then Lord Chaitanya became very ecstatic and he embraced the king.
所以呢，当主柴塔涅马哈巴布听到了 Tava Contemplatum 的时候，所以柴塔涅马哈巴布就变得极乐了，他一下子就抱住了国王。
And he said, he embraced the king. He said, "You have given me invaluable gems."
然后呢，他就抱着国王，对他说，哦，你给了我无价的宝石。
But I have nothing to give you in return.
但是我却没有什么可以回报你的。
So I'm just embracing you.
所以我只能拥抱你。
And Lord Chaitanya began to recite the verse again and again.
然后释迦牟尼佛马哈布就开始一次又一次的诵念这个诗节。
And the king and Lord Chaitanya were both trembling, and tears were flowing from their eyes. So this verse is very beautiful. You may like to learn it yourself. The gopis are saying that they're saying to, of course they're looking where is Krishna, they don't know where it is, but they're praying to him that the nectar of your words and the descriptions of your activities are the life and soul for those devotees who take shelter of you.
所以呢，这个诗节是很美的，也许我们大家呢都可以去学习一下这个诗节。那 Gopi 们呢，他们是在这样唱的，因为他不知道是 Krishna 在哪，他们就说：“您话语的甘露和对您活动的描述，都是在这物质世界里受苦之人的生命之魂。”
For people who are suffering in the material world, then these words are the real shelter.
在这物质世界受苦的人，这些话语都是他们真正的庇护。
And these narrations are transmitted by great personalities.
而且这些话语呢，是由伟大的人物们所传递、讲述。
And they destroy all sinful reactions.
他们就消除了所有的恶报。
And whoever hears these narrations, they get all good fortune.
任何听到这些讲述的人，他们就得到了一切的好运。
These narrations are broadcast all over the world.
而这叙述呢，是在全世界广泛的流传。
And these narrations have great spiritual power.
而且这样的这个讲述呢，是有非常强大的灵性的力量的。
Those people who spread the message of Godhead are the most munificent welfare workers.
那些传播这属神信息的人，无疑是最慷慨的灵性的工作者。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this verse, he embraced the king.
所以当释迦牟尼佛马哈布听完这些话之后呢，他就拥抱了国王。
And he said to the king, "You are the most munificent."
然后呢，他就对国王说：“你是最慷慨的。”
You are the most munificent welfare worker.
你是最慷慨的福利工作者。
So then, Lord Chaitanya didn't even know he was talking to the king.
释迦牟尼佛马哈布他根本就不知道他是在和这位国王在讲话。
So Lord Chaitanya's mercy was given because of the king's wonderful service.
那是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他之所以会给予仁慈的原因呢，就是由于这位国王所做的非常的美妙的服务。
And but Lord Chaitanya didn't even ask who is this man, but Lord Chaitanya just gave his mercy to him.
所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 根本就没有问这人到底是谁，但是呢，他把他的仁慈给了他。
So this is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. Without even inquiring about the king, the Lord Chaitanya made everything possible.
所以说呢，这就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。他根本就没有询问这位国王的身份，他就把一切演绎得如此曼妙。
So anyone who does any service for Krishna, that it's never wasted. It never goes in vain.
所以说呢，任何一个人为 Sri Krishna 所做的任何一点服务都不会是徒劳的。
Lord Krishna says this in the Bhagavad Gita.
那么 Krishna 也在《博迦梵歌》里面讲了这一点。
He says in the second chapter, "Svapa mapyasya dharmasya triyate mahatobaya." Just a little advancement on the path saves you from the greatest danger.
在第二章里面他就讲到了在这路途上的些许进步也保护你免除最危险的恐惧。
So Lord Chaitanya has given us this Sankirtan movement, which is the most powerful method of devotional service.
所以呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就给了我们这 Sankirtan 运动，这是最有力量的奉爱服务的形式。
And anybody who takes to this mercy, they will immediately come to the transcendental position.
任何得到了这个仁慈的人，他立刻都处在了超然之境。
We need to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
那我们需要得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
Just like the King of Puri, he had to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
那么就好像 Puri 的国王一样，他必须要得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
The king wanted to be recognized by Lord Chaitanya.
国王他希望能够被主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所认出来。
So if we do a little service, make a little sincere effort to serve Krishna, then we'll get the success. We'll be able to go back home, back to Godhead.
所以如果我们要是为 Sri Krishna 做了一点服务，我们哪怕是只是付出了一点点真诚的努力的话，为 Sri Krishna 做了服务，我们也都能够回到守神的身边去了。
Yeah, because Lord Chaitanya saw how the king was serving Lord Jagannath, so he saw the king was worthy of his mercy.
因为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他看到了国王是怎么服务主 Jagannath, 所以呢，他就觉得国王是值得到这个仁慈的。
So even though the king changed his dress,Lord Chaitanya didn't ask who is this man. Lord Chaitanya just gave his mercy to him.
所以说呢，虽然说国王他换了他的衣服，但是呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 根本就没有问这人是谁，只是把他的仁慈给了他。
So the author of the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj, he wants to show us the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
Chaitanya Charitamrita 的作者 Krishna Das Kaviraj Maharaj 呢？他希望向我们展示 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
And he wants to show us how Lord Chaitanya gave the mercy to Maharaj Prataparudra.
而且呢，他也想向我们展示 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是如何把他的仁慈给予了 Prataparudra 王的。
So this Krishna consciousness movement is spread by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
所以说呢，Krishna 知觉运动呢，是由 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈
Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful of all of Krishna's incarnations.
那可以说呢，在 Sri Krishna 的所有的化身中 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是最仁慈的一位。
He's delivering, he's giving love of God to everyone.
他把神爱派给了所有的人。
Sometimes we sing the song, "Paramakaruna Pahudvi Channa."Nitai Gora Chandra Paramakaruna Pahud. These two, Dvijana means these two lords, Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, are very, very merciful.
那在这歌中唱的 Dvija 呢，指的是两位主，就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和主 Nityananda， 他们都是非常仁慈的主。
There's no one who can compare to their mercy.
对于他们的仁慈来说呢，其他没有任何人可以比拟的。
And it's also said in another song that Brajendra Nandana se Sachi Sutta Hailahe Balaram Hailo Nitai Dinahina Yatachilo Harinam Udarilo Tarashakshi Jagai Madhai. The mercy of Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda is that they could deliver fallen souls like Jagai and Madhai.
就是由于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 主 Nityananda 的仁慈，使得他们能够拯救像加盖和麻袋这样堕落的灵魂。
So Lord Chaitanya's movement, his special mission is to deliver the fallen souls in the Kali Yuga.
所以说呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他的这个运动的特别的使命，就是拯救在卡利年代的这些堕落灵魂们。
So we have to try to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. And then we become qualified to go back home, back to Godhead. So then Lord Chaitanya turns to the king and he says to the king, Who are you? You have done so much for me.
是查丹尼玛法布呢，就转身对国王说：“你是谁呀？你为我做了这么多事情。”
Suddenly you came here, and you're making me drink the nectar of Krishna's pastimes.
你突然之间来到这里，然后呢，让我来喝饮，是 Krishna 的逍遥时光的蜜露。
So the king says to Lord Chaitanya, "I am the most obedient servant of your servants."
然后国王就对主持丹加马布说：“我是您的仆人的最恭顺的仆人。”
It is my ambition that you will allow me to become the servant of your servants.
那我的雄心壮志就在于您允许我成为您的仆人的仆人。
That's a great thing, a very nice thing. We should want to become a servant of the servants of Krishna.
那这是一个非常美好的想法，就是我们希望让自己成为 Krishna 的仆人的仆人的仆人。
Is it okay?
Yes, yes, I unmute her.
Okay. Nobody should want to become the direct servant of Krishna.
没有任何一个人希望自己成为 Krishna 直接的仆人。
That is not good.
那个不太好。
Prahlad Maharaj was offered the benediction by Lord Narsingadev, but Prahlad said no.
主女辛哈德夫呢就让Prahlad Maharaj 向他讨要仁慈，但是呢 Prahlad Maharaj 说不要。
I don't want any material benediction.
他说呢，我不想要任何的物质的祝福。
Just let me be a servant of your servants.
就是请让我成为您的仆人的仆人。
In the same way, Dhruva Maharaj was offered benediction by Kuvera, the treasurer of the demigods.
那同样呢，半神人里面的财神 Kuvera 也对这个 Dhruva Maharaj 说，请他。从他这里要一个祝福。
So Dhruva could have asked for any kind of wealth from Kuvera.
那 Dhruva 他本来是可以从 Kuvera 那里要得任何的财宝的。
But he said, just let me be the servant of your servants.
但是他说呢，你就允许让我成为你的仆人的仆人。
Who are all servants of the Supreme Lord.
那么所有的这些仆人们都是至尊主的仆人。
And then also Koloveka Sridhar was a very poor man.
Koloveka Sridhar, 他也是一个非常穷苦的人。
And Lord Chaitanya wanted to give him a benediction.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是想给他一个祝福的。
But he said, no, I just want to remain the servant of your servants.
他说不不不，我只是就想始终保持着您的仆人的仆人的位置就好了。
So that's the best benediction we can get.
那么所以这个呢，是我们能够得到的最好的嘉奖。
So Lord Chaitanya showed some of his opulences to the king, but he did not allow him to tell anyone.
那所以说呢，主查丹尼亚马哈布就把他的一些富裕的展现给了国王，但是呢，他让国王不要把这件事情告诉其他任何一个人。
So Lord Chaitanya knew everything, but he didn't discuss it with anybody.
所以查丹尼亚马哈布他是无所不知、无所不晓的，但是呢，他并不会和所有的人去探讨所有的这些事情。
He didn't tell people that I know I was talking with the king. He didn't say that.
他并没有说我知道
he didn't tell other people that he knew that he was talking with the king.
Okay, 他并没有跟别人说他知道他在和这个国王在谈话。
Yeah, he just kept it secret.
所以呢，就只是把这个事情给当成一个秘密就好了。
But all the devotees who saw it, they saw the king get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.And they all said, oh, the king is very fortunate.
他们所有在场的家的奉献者，他们就看到了国王从Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu这得到了仁慈，所以呢，他们就说这国王实在是太幸运了。
So this is the mood of devotees, pure devotees. We shouldn't be envious of other devotees.
那作为一个纯粹的奉献者，他所具备的一个心态就是不应该去嫉妒其他的奉献者吧。
When we see somebody make advancement, we shouldn't be envious. We should be happy for them.
当我们看到其他的奉献者取得进步的时候呢，我们应该为他们高兴，不应该嫉妒他们。
Just like this king got the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
那么就好像这位国王，他从 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 那儿得到了仁慈。
So same way, Prabhupada says.Without the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, we cannot preach Krishna consciousness.
那同样，释迦牟尼佛说呢，如果是没有释迦牟尼佛发布的仁慈的话，我们是不可能传播 Krishna 知觉的。
But still, we get some people who are supposed to be devotees. They don't like to see our Krishna conscious movement spreading around the world.
但是呢，我们还是有一些这个奉献者们，他们。Devotees or non-devotees, they don't want to see.
They're devotees.
Okay. 那么就但是呢，还是有一些奉献者，他们其实并不希望看到我们的Krishna知觉传遍到世界各地的。
Yeah, they find fault with the preachers who go and spread the movement.
他们呢会在传播这个运动的那些传教者身上挑错。
They don't appreciate the fact that they went through, took so many risks, and they accepted so much austerity to go to foreign countries.
他们并没有感激他们经历了这么多苦行，经历了这么多艰难，到国外去传播。
But they just simply criticize them. So this is some envious mentality.
他们仅仅就是在批评他们，所以呢，这是。很嫉妒的一种心态。
So, the king offered prayers and obeisances to Lord Chaitanya, and then he went outside.
所以呢，这位国王呢，他就向主顶拜，然后呢，向主献上了祷恩，然后他就出来了。
And then the devotees brought all the prasada. Lord Chaitanya took lunch with all the devotees.
然后呢，奉献者们就端上了 prasadam， 然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就和所有的奉献者们一起荣耀 prasadam。
And the king also sent a lot of prasadam there for Lord Chaitanya and for all the devotees。
但是国王呢也为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和所有的奉献者们准备了很多的 prasadam。
There were things like uncooked milk and fruits and the best quality of everything。
那里呢有一些就是没有煮过的牛奶，还有一些这个水果，还有这个各种各样的非常上乘的高品质的食物。
all the prasadam which had been offered, that had been cooked by all the brahmanas, it was all brought there. So there was curd.
有 curd 就是奶一种奶酪。
Yeah, right. And then there was fruit juice.
嗯，还有果汁。
And coconut.
还有椰奶，椰子，椰子。
Mango.
芒果。
And then jackfruit.
还有就是 jackfruit.
Bolo mi. Bolo.
对对，菠萝蜜，菠萝蜜，菠萝蜜。
And various kinds of bananas.
还有就是各种各样的香蕉。
And you know, in Orissa, that part of India, there are many different kinds of bananas.
但我们知道，在印度的 Orissa 这个地方呢，有各种各样的香蕉。
And then there were the seeds from the palm fruit.
还有呢，就是从棕榈果，就是棕榈果果籽。
And there were oranges.
还有橘子、橙子。
And grapefruit.
葡萄。
No, no, grapefruit, grapefruit.
柚子，柚子。
柚子 ，right. And tangerines.
还有柑橘。
Almonds.
Almonds.
杏仁。
哦，杏仁，对，杏仁。
Dry fruit.
还有一些干果。
Raisins and dates.
还有就是葡萄干之类的东西，还有枣。
And there were hundreds of different kinds of sweets.
还有各种各样的成百上千道的甜品。
And all different types of condensed milk.
还有各种各样的炼乳。
And then there's papaya.
还有木瓜。
And then there was also a squash which had been crushed.
还有就是西葫芦，就是被 what do you mean by crushed?
Crushed and then smashed and.
就是被压成酱的西葫芦。
And then there was all different kinds of cream.
还有各种各样的乳汁。
And then some cream has even been fried, fried cream.
就还有一些这种这个炼乳制品呢，就是一些奶酪的这个东西，它是把它给炸了的。
And they had a puri made with cream.
还有用炼乳制成的 puri， 制成的饼。
And then there were pomegranates.
还有石榴。
And then sweets made with black pepper.
有黑胡椒做的甜品。
And sweets made with sugar.
有糖做的甜品。
And there was the lotus flower sugar.
还有莲花糖。
And there was a bread made from urdal.
Urdal,
Bai Dou.
Bai Dou, 就是还有用这个白豆所制成的糕点。
And there were different sweets which were fried, had been fried.
还有炸制的甜品。
And there was sugar candy.
还有甜甘蔗。
And sesame sweets.
还有由芝麻做成的甜品。
And biscuits, cookies made from sesame seeds.
由芝麻所做成的各种各样的饼干。
And using the sweets, they made them in the shape. Some sweets were made in the shape. They looked like oranges and lemon and mango.
他们把这个甜品呢，还做成各种各样的形象，比如说有的是像橙子呀，有的像芒果呀。
And there was yogurt and milk and butter and buttermilk.
然后还有牛奶、酸奶，还有乳酪，酸奶制品，酸奶的饮料。
And then preparations made from yogurt.
还有用酸奶所制成的食物。
And there was mundal sprouts, salty mundal sprouts.
还有就是甜味儿的豆汤。
Yeah, yeah, 豆汤 yeah, sprouts.
哦，就是有甜味儿的绿豆芽儿。
With shredded ginger.
这里面呢，就是这个豆芽里面还拌上了擦成丝儿的姜。
And there were various types of pickles.
还有各种各样的咸菜。
And they had like lemon pickle and berry pickle.
比如说呢，是用柠檬啊，还有用浆果制成的咸菜。
And there were so many varieties of food that we cannot describe them all.
那所以有这个食物的种类是非常繁多的，我们没有办法描述所有的食物。
So when Lord Chaitanya saw all the varieties of prasadam, how it was filling the garden, he was very happy.
所以呢，当时查丹尼马哈布看到各种各样的食物充满了整个花园的时候呢，他特别开心。
He was thinking Lord Jagannath had accepted all this food.
那他就在想，主贾格纳特接受了所有的这些食物。
So Prabhupada said, we as devotees, we should also be happy to see nice food offered to the deities.
那所以沙巴巴说呢，作为我们奉献者。当我们看到非常上乘的食物供给神像的时候呢，我们也应该感到非常的开心。
We're not anxious to get all these types of food for our own self, but we want to see all offered to the deity.
但是我们自己不要渴望着能够吃到所有的这些各种各样的食物，但是我们应该非常渴望所有的这些食物都能供奉给神像。
It's part of the duty of the spiritual teacher.To see that the disciples make nice foodstuffs to offer to the deity.
作为灵性导师，他其中有一个职责，就是看到他的门徒能够做各种各样的上乘的食物献给神像。
And after the food is offered to the deity, then it's all distributed.
那么当这个食物供奉给神像之后呢，这些食物要被派发。
Of course, the spiritual teacher, he doesn't need to eat all of these things.
那么当然，灵性导师自己本人并不需要吃到所有的这些食物。
But he likes to see it all distributed to the public.
但是呢，他希望看到这些食物能够派发给大众。
Prabhupada liked to see, he would often, when he would come to the temples, he would want to see what is the prasadam, what are you distributing?
So, when Sarvapapa came to the temple, he would like to see what is the prasadam.
Particularly if we had a public program and we would distribute prasadam at the end of the lecture, Prabhupada would want to see what prasadam we were giving.
特别是我们当有这个对外的节目的时候，在节目的最后呢，我们就会派发 prasadam。那么薛尔爸爸这会儿他就喜欢去看一看，这会儿我们都派的是什么 prasadam。
And then on the Sunday program, when we had a Sunday program and many guests would come, Prabhupada would want to know, he'd say, bring me a plate, I want to see what you're distributing to everyone.
那么在星期天的这个节目的时候呢，因为我们是要向客人派发 prasadam 的。对呢，说了泡饭呢，他就会说，也给我派一盘，我想看看你们给客人都派了些什么盘沙的。
So one time in Los Angeles, the devotees brought sweets for Prabhupada, and the sweets were made with some kind of chocolate.
然后有一次呢，在旧金山，奉献者呢就给说了泡饭盛上了甜品，那么这个甜品呢是用巧克力做的。
And Prabhupada said, what is this? What kind of sweet is this?
然后说爸爸就问这是什么呀？这是什么样的甜品呢？
And Prabhupada said, why don't you make the sweets? I showed you how to make.
然后呢说爸爸就说你为什么不做我教你们做的甜品呢？
Prabhupada taught us to make things like rasgulla and gulab jamun and sandesh and burfi, Bengali sweets.
因为说爸爸呢，他就教我们做了一些孟加拉的这个甜品，比如说 gulab jamun、rasgulla， 还有 sandesh， 还有什么来着？
Bengali，
都是孟加拉的这个甜品。
So Prabhupada said you should make these sweets. These Bengali sweets are pleasing to Krishna.
然后呢，舍尔巴巴就说你们应该学着做孟加拉的甜品，因为这孟加拉的甜品呢是很取悦 Krishna 的。
So, Lord Chaitanya is taking prasadam with all the devotees. All the devotees sat in lines, and Lord Chaitanya personally began to distribute the prasadam.
So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就和所有的奉献者们一起共享 prasadam， 然后所有的这些奉献者们呢就做成了一排一排的，然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢亲自向这些奉献者们派发 prasadam。
He knew the devotees who had been doing kirtan were all tired.So he wanted to give them good prasadam. But the devotees wouldn't eat, and they said, "We're not going to eat until Lord Chaitanya sits down and takes prasadam." So they had to tell Lord Chaitanya, you have to sit down, only then the devotees will eat. So Lord Chaitanya sat down with all the devotees and everybody was fed up to the full, up to the neck.
So Lord Chaitanya sat down with all the devotees and everybody was fed up to the full, up to the neck.
And so then after everybody washed their hands, and then there was so much extra prasadam, it was distributed to thousands of other people. Then Lord Chaitanya told his servants, he said, call for all the poor beggars and feed them.
然后是陈丹妈妈后对仆人说呢，要换来所有的这些穷苦的乞丐们，然后呢把这些食物派给他们 ，prasadam 派给他们。
And when Lord Chaitanya saw the beggars all eating prasadam, Lord Chaitanya chanted Hari Bol, and Lord Chaitanya got them also to chant the holy name.
那么当主陈丹妈妈后看到所有的这些乞丐们在荣耀 prasadam 的时候。所以陈丹妮妈妈不就唱诵着哈利波，然后呢，他也让所有的这些乞丐们一起唱诵了圣名。
So Lord Chaitanya was teaching them, the people, he was telling them, you know, chant the holy name because that means you're also a servant of Krishna.
那然后，所以陈丹妮妈妈就对他们说呢，你们要唱诵圣名，因为这也就意味着你们也是 Sri Krishna 的仆人。
Now everybody wants to come to that level of Krishna consciousness. So Lord Chaitanya was teaching people, even the beggars, to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was teaching people, even the beggars, to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.乞丐也要唱诵哈利克什纳曼陀罗。
And on the transcendental platform, there's no distinction between the rich or the poor.
而且呢，从超人的层面上来讲呢，穷人跟富人之间是没有任何的区别的。
The Prabhupada said, "Don't just give prasadam to the poor; give to the rich also. Don't just give prasadam to the rich; give to the poor also. Don't just go to the poor." The rich also need prasadam. Everyone needs prasadam.
然后呢，所以这丹妮玛伯伯说呢，不要仅仅是把这 prasadam 给予穷人，也要把 prasadam 给予富人。所有的人都需要 prasadam。
So, sorry, I just had to take care of my body for a minute. Okay, so the beggars were all chanting Hari Bol, And they all became ecstatic.
那所有的这些乞丐们都在唱诵着哈利波，而且所有人都变得非常的极乐。
So we should give Krishna consciousness to everyone without discrimination.
那所以说，我们也应该没有任何分辨心的把 Krishna 直觉给所有的人。
In the spiritual world, there's no high and low class. Everybody's the same.
在灵性世界是没有高等人和低等人的，所有人都是一样的。
So we want to see all the people equally.
那所以说呢，我们希望能够平等的对待所有的人。
So, Lord Chaitanya came out of the garden, and it was time to pull the chariot.
那所以呢？主持人妈妈妈呢她就从花园里面走出来了，然后呢是又要拉车的时间了。
But they were trying to pull it, but it wouldn't move forward, it wouldn't move.
但是呢他们就使劲的拉这个车，可是这车呢就一点也不动。
So then they called the king, and the king was in anxiety, and the king, he got some very big, strong wrestlers to come.
然后呢，这个他们就换来了这个国王。国王这会儿非常的焦虑，所以呢，他就安排了一位身强力大的摔跤手来了。
But the king, but all the strong men, big strong men, and the king himself, they all joined in, but still the car wouldn't move.
所以说呢，就是这些身强力大的人，还有国王本人，都在使劲的拉这个车，但这车呢，它就是一动不动。
So the king became more anxious.So then he got some big elephants to come. And they put the harness on, they put this big harness around the elephants, and they had these elephants pull, but still the car wouldn't move an inch. So then Lord Chaitanya heard about it and he came with all the devotees. And Lord Chaitanya was watching, the elephants were trying to pull, and the men on there was the men beating the elephants, and the elephants were crying. But still the car, the chariot wouldn't move. The people were saying, Aya, Aya.
但是呢，就这车它就是一点也不动，所以人们都在说，哎呀，哎呀。
So then Lord Chaitanya said, get the elephants, take the elephants away.
And so,
now give the chariot, the ropes of the chariot, put them in the hands of our devotees. And then Lord Chaitanya went to the back of the chariot and he began to push with his head.
然后呢，水车丹加玛巴布呢就来到了车的后面，他就开始用他的头来顶这个车。
And the car, the chariot, big chariot began to roll and made a rattling sound.
那么这会儿呢，这辆巨大的车子，它又开始发着这个滚动的这个声音移动了。
No, the devotees didn't even need to pull. They just held the rope in their hands, and the chariot was moving on its own.
奉献者们根本就不需要拖这个车，他们不过是比划着手里拿着这个绳子而已，这个车子自己就动了。
And then when the people saw the chariot move, they all cried, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath.
那当他们看到车子又动起来的时候呢，他们都大声呼唤着 Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath.
And then the car came to the door of the Gundicha temple.
然后呢，这个车子就来到了孔蒂沙庙的门口。
Everyone was just amazed to see the strength of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那所有人呢都非常的惊愕的看着 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所具有的巨大的力量。
And people were all chanting, Jai Gaurachandra, Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
所有人都在大声的呼唤着 Jai Gaurachandra, Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
Tai Mei Miao, wonderful.
太美妙了。
Seeing the great, and then Lord Chaitanya, the king and all the men, they were so ecstatic, their hairs were standing on end to see these pastimes with Lord Chaitanya.
那么所有的这些看着水城丹田马花布的逍遥时光的人呢，都非常的极乐，然后他们露出了这个极乐的真相，就是所有的毛发都竖起来了。
So then they brought Lord Jagannath off the chariot and they brought him into the throne, put him on his throne.
那然后呢，他们就把主驾那个请下了车子，并且呢把他请到了神坛上。
And they brought
他的那个座位上。
Lord Balaram and Subhadra Maharani, they also came.
接着呢，他们也把主巴拉让和苏巴卓马哈拉尼也都请到了他们各自的位置上。
And then they had a little bathing of Lord Jagannath, and then finally offered the food to the deities.
然后呢，他们为主迦那的做了一个简单的沐浴，之后呢，把这个食物献给供奉给了神像。
And Lord Chaitanya and all the devotees, they were doing sankirtan.
那么当时 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 以及所有的这些奉献者呢，又开始进行了 Sankirtan。
Lord Chaitanya was in ecstasy, and all the people who saw him, they were also in ecstasy.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是处于极乐之中，当时在场的所有的这些奉献者们也都是极乐开怀。
And then they had arti in the evening, and Lord Chaitanya came and saw the arti.
刚在晚上的时候呢，他们做了 arti， 主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢也来观看灯仪。
And then for 9 days, it went on for 9 days.And devotees like Advaita Acharya, they had the opportunity to invite Lord Chaitanya to their home.
那然后呢？接着这九天的这个时间里面，有一些奉献者，比如说像 Advaita Acharya， 就这样的奉献者就有机会请 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到他们的家里去。
So they were staying. They'd come there. They were staying there for the Chaturmasya, which is 4 months.So they had different people got an opportunity to invite the Lord to come and take prasadam at their home.
因为呢，他们要在这儿待，主彩太娘王后要在这儿待一段时间，因为是 Chaturmasya， 也就是四月苦行的时候，那么就使得有不少人都有机会请水彩太娘王后到他们家中去荣耀prasadam。
So there were so many devotees, not everybody got an opportunity to invite Lord Chaitanya.
但是呢，因为奉献者太多了，并不是所有的奉献者都有这个机会能够邀请 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So sometimes 2 or 3 devotees would join together, and they would cook for Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，有的时候呢，这个两位或三位奉献者他们会合起来一起为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 做饭。
So Lord Chaitanya would wake up early in the morning and take his bath, and then he would go to see Lord Jagannath in the temple.
那所以呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他会清晨起身之后呢，先去沐浴，然后呢，他就会到庙里面去觐见主 Jagannath.
And they would do sankirtan, they'd be chanting and dancing, and Lord Chaitanya would get other devotees like Lord Nityananda and Advaita to chant and dance.
然后呢，他们就会进行 sankirtan， 他们就会唱诵，他们就会跳舞。然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，也会让其他的奉献者，比如说像主 Nityananda 和主 Advaita， Advaita Acharya 一起来唱诵跳舞。
And sometimes you get Haridas Thakur to dance。
他有的时候呢，也会请 Haridas Thakur 跳舞。
And then Vakreshwara Pandit, he was a great dancer. Lord Chaitanya would get him to dance。
而且呢 ，Vakreshwara Pandit。他也是一位非常伟大，就是了不起的舞者，所以呢，水城丹娘马花布呢也会请他来跳舞。
So every day, 3 times a day, they would have sankirtan.
所以说呢，在一天中呢，有3次他们都会进行 sankirtan.
They'd have it in the morning, they'd have sankirtan again at noon, and then in the evening again.
那所以呢，他们就会在清晨、 然后在午间以及在晚上都会进行 Sankirtan。
And so Lord Chaitanya, by doing Sankirtan, he felt like Lord Krishna had come back to Vrindavan.
所以就是通过这样的 Sankirtan 呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就觉得 Sri Krishna 回到了 Vrindavan。
So his feeling of separation from Krishna was subsided.
所以说呢，他对 Sri Krishna 的这种分离之情就变得默化了下来。
Lord Chaitanya was always thinking about the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他时刻都在意念着 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥。
And he would always be in that consciousness.
所以呢，他总是处在那样的知觉中的。
So there were many gardens just near to the Gaudiya temple.
在贡迪彻庙的附近呢，有很多的花园。
And Lord Chaitanya used to perform pastimes of Vrindavan in these different places.
那所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，之前会在这些地方上演在 Vrindavan 的逍遥。
And there's a big lake just near the Gaudiya temple, which is named the Indradyumna Lake.
在贡迪彻庙旁边呢，有一座湖。这座湖呢，被命名为 Indradyumna 湖。
Of course, the king of Puri was Indradyumna, so it was named after him.
那当然了，这个 Puri 的国王的名字就是 Indradyumna, 所以这座湖呢是以他的名字而命名的。
So the Lord Chaitanya went into the lake and began to play in the lake. He began to splash all the devotees with water.
所以呢，去查丹尼玛法布呢，就来到这个湖里面，然后呢，就和所有的奉献者们开始在湖里面开始玩耍起来。
So all the devotees, they got round. Everybody is splashing each other.
那所有的这些奉献者们呢，他们都在彼此之间相互泼水。
And sometimes they'd be in circles, and sometimes they'd one person against another.
对他们有的时候呢是这个围着圈在玩，有的时候呢是一个人在被其他的人就是彼此之间相互打。
And sometimes, although they were in the water, some of them would be playing kartals.
还有的时候呢，虽然是在水里面，但是还会有人打挠脖。
And others would be imitating the croaking of frogs.
而且呢，还有人呢，他就会学乌鸦青蛙的叫声。
And they sometimes they go in pairs and they'd fight each other.
还有的时候呢，他们可能会组成这个一对一对的彼此之间相互的打斗。
So Lord Chaitanya was watching all the fun.
所以说所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就看着所有他们做的这些游戏。
Advaita Acharya was fighting Lord Nityananda.
Advaita Acharya 是在和朱尼天丹打。
Advaita Acharya got defeated.
Advaita Acharya 就被打败了。
And Lord Nityananda called him many bad names.
然后呢，朱尼天丹的呢就对他说了好多脏话。
And then Srivas and Gadarhar, they were also fighting with each other.
然后呢。Srivas 和 Gadadhar 他们呢也在彼此之间的相互打斗。
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he was also fighting with Ramananda Roy.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢是在和 Ramananda Roy 在彼此之间相互打斗。
Now, the Bhattacharya and Ramananda Roy was the governor.And Bhattacharya, they're both very senior people, and usually are very grave. But when they started fighting in the water, they lost their gravity and they became like children.
那么这个 Ramananda Roy 呢，他本来是个政府的高官，而Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢，也是一位德高望重的人物。他们俩人其实是非常的年长的，而且呢，经常也是很严肃的。可是当他们在水里面一打斗的时候呢，他们就失去了他们往日的那个庄严的那个状态，就像两个小孩一样在打斗着。
So Lord Chaitanya was watching and he was smiling.
那么所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就看着，然后脸上露出着笑容。
And he had to tell the Bhattacharya and Ramananda Roy, he said, tell them that stop their childish play because they are both very.Intelligent and very learned scholars.
然后呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就必须要阻止， Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 和 Ramananda Roy 的像孩子般的打闹，因为呢，他们两人都是德高望重的、非常的有智慧的学者。
And they're both great personalities. They shouldn't be behaving like children.
那他们都是非常了不起的伟大人物，所以他们不应该像小孩这样。
So this is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. One drop of the ocean of the mercy of Lord Chaitanya swells up.
所以呢，这就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所显现的一滴仁慈。
One drop of the mercy of Lord Chaitanya can drown a great mountain like Sumeru Mountain or Mandara Mountain.
但是呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的一滴仁慈就可以淹没整座的梅鲁山或者是曼德拉山。
These two men, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Ramananda Roy, they're like little hills in comparison to those mountains.
那么如果是和这个山来相比呢？Ramananda Roy 和 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他们就像是两座小山丘一样。
That's why they're drowning in the ocean of mercy.
所以为什么他们就会被淹没在仁慈的密路之中？
So the Bhattacharya, he was a logician before Lord Chaitanya made him a devotee.
那么Bhattacharya 他在被 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 转换成奉献者之前呢，他是一个逻辑学家。
But logic is like a dry oil cake from which all the oil has been taken out.
那么这个逻辑学它其实就像是一块被榨干了的饼一样，就是所有的这个油都被抽掉了。
So the Bhattacharya, he passed his life eating all this dry cake.
所以呢 ，Bhattacharya 他一直把他这一生都用在去吃这些被抽干了油的饼上。
But now Lord Chaitanya has made him drink the nectar of transcendental pastimes.
但是现在呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就让他喝到了超然的蜜露，超然逍遥的蜜露。
So Lord Chaitanya was smiling, very happy, and then he called for Advaita Acharya, and he told Advaita Acharya, you should become like Seshanag, and I will lay on you, you can be my bed.
Okay, 那么Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就非常开心地笑着，然后等了一会儿以后呢，他就唤来了Advaita Acharya, 他说呢，你可以让你自己成为一个Seshanag,那我呢可以把你当成床一样睡在上面。
So Advaita Acharya lay down on the water, floating on the water, and Lord Chaitanya got on top of him.
所以呢Advaita Acharya 他就躺在了水里，然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就睡在了他躺在水里的身上。
So Advaita Acharya was floating, and Lord Chaitanya was sitting on top of him.
所以呢Advaita Acharya 呢他就浮在水上。而 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，就落在他的身上。
Just like Lord Vishnu sitting on Seshanaga.
就好像主 Vishnu 坐在 Seshanaga 上一样。
And so after playing like this for some time, then Lord Chaitanya went back to his place, went back to where he was staying.
就是像这样玩了一段时间之后呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就回到了他自己的住处。
And they took prasadam together.
他们一起融了 prasadam.
And whatever extra prasadam was taken by the devotees of Lord Chaitanya.
Okay, 然后呢，这个奉献者呢，就还如果还剩下一些这个多余的这些 prasadam 呢，奉献者就荣耀了，就是荣耀了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 荣耀过的 prasadam。
And then in the afternoon, Lord Chaitanya went to Gundicha Temple to see the Lord and to chant and dance.
然后在下午的时候呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就又会去到 Gundicha 庙去见主，并且呢去唱诵、去跳舞。
So every day this would be like Lord Chaitanya's program.
所以这就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的每天的安排。
So he went, then Lord Chaitanya would go into the garden and they would have the pastimes of Vrindavan. And you should understand Lord Chaitanya going into the garden to do pastimes of Vrindavan. It's not that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to imitate Lord Krishna. Lord Chaitanya was never in the mood of Krishna, he was always in the mood of Radharani. And he always had the mood of enjoying the company of Krishna. So we shouldn't think Lord Chaitanya is like Jagannath. He's not like Krishna, he's not like Jagannath, but he's a servant. Lord Chaitanya never associated with women or with the wives of other men. So there were many beautiful trees and creepers in the garden, and they were all happy to see Lord Chaitanya. So the birds were chirping, and the bees were buzzing, and there was a beautiful, cool breeze. And the one devotee named Vasudev Datta, he began to sing, and he would sing different songs under each tree, and Lord Chaitanya would dance in ecstasy. Then Lord Chaitanya told Vakreshwara Pandit to dance. And at that time Lord Chaitanya sang himself. And there were other devotees to lead the kirtan, and they would have wonderful kirtan. Everyone would feel so much love for Krishna. All the devotees lost all consciousness of time because the kirtan was so sweet and nobody thought about time. Then the devotees went to another lake called the Narendra Sarova, and they began to enjoy there. So during this time, Lord Chaitanya stayed and performed the pastimes with his devotees. Every day like this. So there was a special festival called the Hera Panchami Festival, which had to take place. So the king was organizing the festival very carefully. He said, tomorrow is going to be the Hera Panchami festival, and we want to make it very wonderful. Right. Panchami means 5 days, so this festival takes place 5 days after the Rath Yatra.
Panchamid 的意思呢就是五天，也就是说呢这个五天的节日是在弹车节之后发生的。
Lord Jagannath had left his wife, who is the goddess of fortune, and gone to Vrindavan.
嗯，主加格纳则离开了他的妻子，也就是幸运女神，然后去到了 Vrindavan。
Vrindavan is actually the Gundicha temple.
那这个 Vrindavan 其实就是贡蒂彻庙。
But the goddess of fortune becomes disturbed. She feels separation from her husband, and she comes to look for him.
但是呢，这个幸运女神呢，她这会儿心就是这个，心乱如麻，因为呢，她非常的思念她的丈夫，所以呢，她就开始出来找她的丈夫。
So that when the goddess of fortune comes to the Gundicha temple, this is called the Hera Panchami festival.
所以说呢，当幸运女神来到贡蒂彻庙找她的丈夫的时候，这就被称为叫 Hera Panchami 节。
The word Hera means to see.
Hera 的意思呢是去看。
Yeah, the goddess of fortune is going to see Lord Jagannath.
也就是说呢，幸运女神将要见到主加格纳特。
And Panchami means the fifth day.
Panchami 的意思呢，就是五天。
Right, 50 after the Rathiatra took place.
Sorry, the fifth day, right?
Yeah, the fifth day.
对不起，我刚才翻的有点不对，就是这个 Panchami 的意思呢，是说是第五天，也就是说呢，是在弹车节过后的第五天所进行的节日。
Right.So the king said, we want to make this festival very gorgeous. We want Lord Chaitanya to be very pleased.
那所以国王就说呢，我们要非常盛大的呈现这个节日，我们要让 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 非常的开心过节。
So we should have nice paraphernalia. We need many bells and cloths and chamaras.
所以呢，我们要准备很多很多的物品，我们要准备很多的铃铛。很多的这个布料，也有很多的浮尘。
And have many flags and ringing bells.
而且呢，我们要准备很多的这个彩旗，还有摇动的铃铛。
And have a lot of musical parties and dancing parties.
而且呢，我们要这个组织好很多的乐队和舞蹈的队伍。
Like, because they're going to carry the goddess of fortune on her palanquin, and that will be her carrier, and around her, along with her, there should be all these musical parties and dancing parties.
然后呢，我们要因为要用轿子抬着幸运女神，然后呢，在这个轿子的周围呢，就要安排很多的乐队，很多的舞蹈队伍。
And then the king said, you should double the quantity of prasadam.
然后国王就说呢，我们要准备双倍的 prasadam.
It should be even more than what we had at Rathiatra.
就是这个 prasadam 呢，要比我们在弹车节的时候准备的 prasadam 还要多。
And you should make the arrangements so that Lord Chaitanya can easily go to see the deities.
而且呢，我们应该做出一番安排，使得主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢很容易就能够见到神像。
So the next morning, Lord Chaitanya, along with his devotees, they all went to see Lord Jagannath.
所以第二天清晨呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和他所有的奉献者们都一起去见主 Jagannath.
When Lord Jagannath is in Gundicha, that place is called Sundarachala.
那么当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在贡蒂彻庙，就当这个加格纳特在贡蒂彻庙的时候，这个地方被称为叫 Sundarachala。
Yes, but when Lord Jagannath is at Jagannath Puri, that place is called Nilachala.
但是呢，当主加格纳特在加格纳普里的时候，这个地方被称为叫 Nilachala。
Right, Nila, Nilachala. Nila means blue color.
Nila means what, Sir Marshall?
Blue.
Blue. Oh, okay. 这个 Nila 的意思呢是蓝色。
And Sundar means very attractive, very beautiful.
Sundar 的意思呢是非常有吸引力，非常美丽。
So we often hear Nila Chala Chandra Jaya Jaya Jagannath, Nila Chala Chandra Jaya Jaya Jagannath. Nilachala, Nilachala. That's it.
Do you know what Nilachala Chandra Jaya Jagannath?
So Gundicha is Sundarachala. So Lord Chaitanya and all of his devotees, they went to Nilachala to see this festival.
They go to Nilachala to see the festival.
Yeah, because they're going, because the festival begins at Nilachala. The goddess of fortune, she's still in Jagannath Puri, and she's going to come to Gundicha.
Lord
Jagannath had gone to Vrindavan and he hadn't come home. And so his wife is becoming anxious. Where's my husband? So she's going to come and see him. Do we have any questions there?
Yes, I do see one question here.
Maybe we should take questions.
Okay. 当我们在节日上供奉 Rasa Gula 后派发给奉献者时，大多数都觉得太甜了，无法品味，不太能接受。请问 Gurudev， 这是我们没有灵性品味，还是物质口味的问题？Maharaj, thank you very much for your very sweet lecture. In our festival, when we offer Rasa Gula and after that distribute the Rasa Gula to the devotees, most of the devotees think the Rasa Gula is too sweet, cannot be. It's hard for them to accept. So my question is that, is this because we haven't really developed that spiritual taste yet, or is because of our material condition?
Yes, it's your material condition.
这是因为我们的物质口味的问题。
Because usually you don't eat many sweets in your regular cooking.
就是因为呢，就是在咱们每天吃饭的这个口味里面，我们是不太习惯吃太多的甜品的。But
in the Bengali culture, it's customary that if ever a guest comes to your home, when the guests come, they will give you a plate of sweets.
但是呢，在孟加拉的这个文化，就是当有客人来到这个家里的时候，首先就要给客人献上一盘甜品。Or
you go to meet someone, sometimes like in. In Calcutta, we go to meet different people in their offices, and we go to their office, and the man will offer you, they take some sweet and give you a plate with a couple of rasgullas on it.
那就比如说我们在加尔各答，在印度的时候去拜访人家，或者是到别人家的这个到别人的办公室里面去的时候，他招待你的首先就是给你一盘甜品，然后这甜品里面就有rasa gula.
So it's just. Culture that Bengali people, they have that habit to eat sweets, you know, that's something they like to give to people when the people come to their home. It's a traditional Bengali sweet.
那所以说呢，这是文化的问题。这个孟加拉人呢，他们其实是很喜欢吃甜品的，而且呢，就是当有客人来的时候呢，他们就愿意把这孟加拉的甜品来招待客人。
You know, just like you have in, you have your dim sum, or your moon cake, you know.
那就好像就我们有我们的点心，有我们的月饼一样。But Maharaj, because earlier you said that Sri Prabhupada said that we're better to prepare the, Bengal style of sweets, because that will be more pleased to Lord Krishna. However. If we offer, you know, like moon cake and dumpling, the Chinese sweets to the Lord, do you think the Lord will be pleased?
Well,
please allow me to translate. 就我不好意思啊，我是接着萨提玛姐这个问题问了一句，因为 Guru Maharaj 刚才就讲到呢，就是我们最好是准备孟加拉的这种甜品，这样的更取悦 Sri Krishna。 说但是呢如果要是我们为 Krishna 献上了比如说像是汤圆啊或者是像是月饼这样的甜品的话那 Krishna 能不能被取悦呢
Well, as far as what you offer to the deities, you know, if you're offering to the deities, you definitely would like to offer the things which are most pleasing to Lord Krishna. And, you know, traditionally, Prabhupada taught us to make things like what I said, you know, like sandesh and rasgulla and these things, you know.
是这样的，就是如果是从崇拜，就是供奉神像的这个角度来考虑的话呢，毫无疑问，我们是希望向神像，也就是向 Krishna 献上他最喜欢的东西。那就比如说，Śrīla Prabhupāda教给我们所做的这些东西，像刚才Maharaj所提到的，像 Rasagula 呀，还有像 Sandesh 这样的甜品。
We have to understand when we talk about offering to the deity is Krishna himself, and he's coming to be there in our home or in the temple, and to accept our worship.
那我们要明白，就当我们在崇拜神像的时候，其实神像就是 Śrī Krishna 本人。那他呢是来到我们家里面或者来到庙里面来接受我们对他的崇拜的。
So we have to think what he likes, not what we like.
所以呢我们就必须要想着神像到底喜欢什么而不要去想着我们喜欢什么。
We're thinking what we like.
Yes, yes. 所以因为我们其实还是把我们把自己放在了中间我们在想我们到底喜欢什么。
So, we have to think more what Krishna likes.
对，所以我们要更多的去想 Krishna 到底喜欢什么。Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj. 下一个问题 ，the next question. The next question from Shruti Rupa Maharaj, 顶拜Guru和老师们，请问Guru，如果从户外大自然中摘野花回家，是不是有业报的偷盗行为呢？还有就是，如果从城市所居住的小区里偷花，这样能被允许吗 ？Ramaji, please accept the merit obeisances due to all the devotees. My question is that if we pick the flowers in the wild area, then bring back home to offer to the deity, is this have any karmic reaction? And the other thing is that if we pick up the flowers from our community area.Is that, will that consider as a behavior of stolen or is this a kind of allowed activity? Thank you.
Well, you have to be careful.
你必须得小心。
You know, you go to a wild area, hillside, you pick flowers. No, I don't think that's a problem. I think that's good. You can bring them back and give them to Krishna. There's no karma, certainly. It's an act of devotion.
那如果你要是去到大自然的这个野地里面，然后呢，在那儿把野花给摘回家，然后把它给献给 Sri Krishna 的话，这是很好的一个行为，这是没有业报的这个产生的，而且呢，这是一个挺好的一个服务的行为。
But if we go in the public place in the government land where the government have planted flowers and we take the flowers, then if you get caught, then it's not good.
但是如果我们要是就比如到了这个社区里边或者就是政府城市规划的这个地区它里面长满了花然后我们要是把这花摘下来然后呢还被抓住了的话这不太好
Yeah, you may be punished, you have to pay money to them.
因为呢我们可能还会受罚而且还得交罚款。
So, you have to be careful.
所以呢必须得小心。
We don't want to get a bad name also that, oh, you're stealing, these Hare Krishna people are stealing all the flowers.
而且呢我们也不想有这么一个坏名声就是这些信Hare Krishna的人他们到处偷花。
The devotees in Australia did this one time.
在澳大利亚的奉献者有一次就干了这件事。
They were having a Rath Yatra.So they went to, there was one place where this one, some man, he had a big piece of land and he had greenhouses and he was growing many flowers in his greenhouse.
那当时呢他们就有一个弹车节然后呢有这么一个人他 有一大块花园，然后他在这个花园里面呢还有这个温房，然后在温房里面呢就种了好多好多的鲜花。
So what happened was the devotees went to this man's greenhouse in the night and they took all the flowers, they cut all the flowers.
然后发生的事情呢就是奉献者晚上的时候呢就偷偷地溜进了这个人的这个温房里面，然后呢就把所有的花都给偷走了，都给剪下来了。
And so they decorated the chariots with all these flowers which they'd taken from the man's greenhouse.
然后呢他们就把从这个人的这个暖房里面所偷来的这个花来装饰着他们的弹车。
But when they were having the Rathyatra festival, the Rathyatra festival was going through the streets, and the man who had the greenhouse, he saw all of his flowers, and he saw that these are all the flowers which I had.
然后呢，就是当这个车子从街上穿行而过的时候呢，就被有着温房，就是有着暖房的这个人就看见了，然后他就看见在车上的上面所有的这些花都是他的花。
So he was really, really upset that, oh, but these are my flowers. These people have stolen my flowers.
当时他就气死了，他说其实都是我的花，这些人把我的花给偷走了。
Of course, he couldn't prove it.
那他也没有办法去证实。
But what happened a few days later, the devotees were trying, some devotee was thinking he wanted to build a greenhouse and start growing flowers for themselves. And
但是呢过了
go ahead.
但过了几天之后呢，奉献者就在想，他们也应该自己搭一个暖房，然后呢自己来种花。
And so the devotee was going around and he saw this greenhouse and he thought, oh, let's go and ask this man about greenhouses.
然后这位奉献者呢 ，so this devotee actually is different devotee who's not.
Yeah, it's a different devotee. Yeah.
这位奉献者呢，就是没有参与当时偷花的一位奉献者哈，然后就看见了，就这个人他的这个暖房之后呢，他就在想，要不然我进去问问他这个暖房到底都是怎么建起来的呢？
So he stopped his car and he got out and he was dressed as a devotee and he said, "Excuse me, sir, we're interested in greenhouses."
然后呢，他就把他车停下来，然后他因为他穿的是奉献者的装束，他就对这个人说，他说。老家，请问您，我们现在呢很感兴趣，想要建一个暖房。
The man looked at him and said, "You please get off my land."
然后呢，这男的就特别的生气的对他说，你赶紧从我的这个地上走开。
He didn't want to see devotees. He knew the devotees had stolen all his flowers.
因为呢，他知道奉献者把他所有的花都给偷了，所以说呢，他根本就不想跟奉献者有任何的交道。
So, you know, if you can take the flowers without getting caught, then it's all, you could say it's okay. But if you get caught, then it's very bad.
所以呢，是这样的啊，就是如果要是你能设法在没有被抓的情况下，要是能够弄点这花的话呢，还是应该可以的。但如果要是被抓住了的话，那可就太难看了。
Srila Prabhupada used to use always eucalyptus twigs to clean his teeth.
那么这个 Srila Prabhupada 呢，他经常会用 ，I know the word, but eucalyptus， 就一种特别的这种植物。然后呢，他用这个植物的这个枝来清理他的牙齿。
Right, so there was a tree of like of this wood. Prabhupada told the devotee, "Get a twig from that tree."
然后呢，就有这么一棵这个树，我忘了这个树的中文名字叫什么，就是这个树呢。然后沙发发就对奉献者说：“你去把这个树上的这个枝摘下来给我。”
So, devotee somehow got up the tree, broke a branch off, and came down. And that time, a policeman came.
然后呢，这个奉献者呢，就爬上那棵树，然后呢摘，就是撅了一根树枝。这会儿呢，警察来了。
And the policeman said to him, "You know, this is government property. You're breaking the property of the government by breaking that shoe, that tree."
然后呢，警察就对他说，这是政府的财产。那你如果是把这个枝给摘下来的话，也就是说你破坏了政府的财产，破坏了公物。
after the policeman went away, Prabhupada said, he said, their government, the British government, they went to India and they took all the gold and all the jewels and brought them all back to London.
然后呢，这个警察走了以后呢，说，这个英国的政府他们去到了印度，然后掠夺了在印度的所有的这些金银、这些这个财宝，然后呢，把这些贵重的物品全部都带回到了英国。Yeah,
there's a crown, which is the crown of the Queen of England, and it has all the best jewels, and they actually were all taken from India.
英国的国王所戴的皇冠，这皇冠上镶嵌着很多的珠宝，所有的这些珠宝都是他们从印度掠夺回来的。
So Prabhupada said, we took one little twig and they're getting so upset.
然后说我们只不过是摘了一根小树枝，他们就这么生气。
They're the big thieves.
他们其实才是最大的贼。
Everything belongs to Krishna. All the flowers, they're meant to be offered to Krishna. But not everyone has that understanding.
那么所有的一切呢，都是属于Krishna的，所有的一切呢，都应该献给Krishna，但并不是所有人都有这样的理解。
So we have to be careful.
那所以呢，我们必须要非常的小心。
Okay.
The next question from Beijing Center, 徐小渊的问题。 Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru的莲花族。 感恩翻译的翻译，谢谢您。刚刚咕噜讲到了竹田丹尼亚给大家派给帕沙丹时，大家吃到了嗓子眼儿。我最近也每天每顿都吃到嗓子眼儿。这里的帕沙丹特别的丰富美味，控制食欲太难了，而且奉献者们都热情地说，新奉献者要多吃。当发觉自己体重飙升时，就想到了国家放歌说吃的太多或太少，睡得太多或太少都不利于修行，我就迷惑了。 请问Guru给予食量和睡眠时间的指导，感恩亲爱的Guru。This question, you got it?
Well, most of it, not all of it.
Okay, this question is from Xi Xiaoyuan, and she paid her humble obeisances to your lotus feet, and he said that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu distributed the prasadam to everyone, and everyone has a full prasadam reached to their throat. And then, actually, recently, I'm living in the temple, so I also have lots of prasadam every day, full prasadam every meal, because the prasadam here is so tasty. So I found it's very hard to control my desire for food. And also, the devotees here are so enthusiastically said that the new devotees should eat more. But I find out, but I find that I'm even gaining weight. So I remember that from Bhagavad Gita, it is said that if you eat too much or eat too little, or sleep too much, sleep too little, neither of them is favorite to the spiritual practice. So I am a little bit bewildered about this. So could you kindly guide me? What is the right amount of food to eat, and also what is the right amount of sleeping to get? Thank you very much.
Yes, well, Vedic system is you should take water before the meal, not after the meal.
这个伟达的体系告诉我们，我们在吃饭之前要先喝水，而不是在吃完饭之后喝水。
So water before the meal is like nectar.
这个在饭前的这个水呢，就好像是甘露一样。Water
during the meal is like medicine.
但是呢，在吃饭中间喝的水呢，就像是药。And
water after the meal is like poison.
而在饭后所喝的水呢，就像是毒药。And
another thing is, when you take food, you should take one third food, one third water, and leave one third for air in your belly.
Okay, 然后呢，就是当你在吃饭的时候呢，在你的这个胃里面呢，你要用三分之一是用食物，放到你的胃里面，然后呢，三分之一的胃里是水，然后另外三分之一呢是空气。
And you know also from China that we say in the morning eat good breakfast, at lunch eat full, and eat very less at night.
那么在中国呢，我们有这样一个说法，就是要吃一顿非常丰盛的早餐，然后呢，午餐的时候要吃饱，在晚餐的时候呢要吃少。
Best thing is you don't eat at night.
最好的做法呢，就是别吃晚饭。
Yeah, we had one Chinese doctor come. He came to treat Jaipataka Swami Maharaj, and he was telling all of us, he said, I can cure any of your health problems if you don't eat after 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
当时呢，咱们中国有一位大夫，他到了马尔福为 Jaipataka Maharaj 治病。他当时就说呢，如果你们要是能够保证在下午2点钟以后不吃饭，那我就能够把你们所有的身体问题给治好。
And the Ayurveda also says that the power of digestion increases as the sun rises, and then it decreases as the sun sets.
然后呢，这个阿育吠达的理论呢也说，就是当这太阳升起的时候，我们的消化力就提升了。那么当这个太阳落山的时候呢，我们的消化力也就减弱了。
So, don't eat.Too much at night, and try to eat your main meal in the middle of the day.
那所以说呢，就是尽量在晚上就不要进食了，然后尽量是在一天中这个中午的时间呢吃你的这一顿午餐。
And you will do better if you don't sleep during the day. Try to just sleep in the night.
睡觉呢也是，就尽量在这一天的白天的时间呢就不要睡觉，然后在晚上的时候才睡。
And if you eat at night, then you won't sleep so well.
因为如果你要是晚上吃东西的话呢，就不会睡得太好。
And you'll wake up feeling uncomfortable in the morning.
而且呢，在清晨醒来的时候呢，也会觉得不舒服。
As far as how much to sleep, well, Prabhupada said it depends. Some people need, well,It's first of all eating. Some people need to eat more. Some people will eat less.
然后关于吃的这个量呢，就是取决于个人。有些人可能吃的需要多一点，有些人呢就要吃的少一些。
So if you're putting on weight, that is not very good for you.
但如果要是你因为吃东西而这个飙升了体重的话，那也就意味着这对你不是太好。
So be careful about eating.Heavy food like rice and breads.
所以说呢，当你在吃一些就是比较重的这个食物的时候，比如说像吃米饭呐，还有像吃面包啊这类东西的时候，要小心。
One of our devotees, one of the devotee family I know, I was visiting them one time, and their daughter was at school, and the daughter came home, and she said the teacher told her.The teacher told her mother that your daughter is eating too much rice. Don't give her so much rice to eat.
那我有一次在旅行的时候呢，住在一个奉献者的家里。那么在这家里面有一个小姑娘，这小姑娘她回家之后呢，她的这个老师对她的妈妈说，就是这个小姑娘吃米饭吃的太多了，一定要控制她的米饭的进量。
Because the teacher could see that the little girl was putting on weight. And usually when you put on weight, it's because you eat too much of the heavy food like rice and breads and wheat, you know.
那通常来说呢，就是因这个长肉长体重的原因呢，就是因为吃了太多这种过重的食物，比如说米面，还有就是小麦类的食物。
Okay, and then sleeping, you want to be careful. You should sleep somewhere between 6 hours to 7 hours is also okay. You know, don't sleep, but don't sleep more than 8 hours.
关于睡觉的这个量呢，要睡到6个小时、7个小时也没问题，但是不要睡超过8个小时。
We try to regulate the eating and the sleeping.
然后呢，我们就尽量的要让我们的吃饭和我们的睡觉要有规律。
So, try to eat the same amounts at the same time, and then sleep also the same time.
而且呢，就是尽量的是在， 同一个时候吃进食，以及在同一个时间去睡觉。
Okay.
You mean keep the consistency?
Yeah, try to keep the regulation.
Yeah, 就是尽量让自己要做到有规律，要做到一致。
嗯。Okay.
Yeah, 下面是问大问的 Ishvari Mataji, 顶拜咕噜，如果因为身体原因无法吃甜食，该怎样给 Krishna 做饭呢？Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. If because of the physical reason, I cannot take the sweet food, so in this case, how to prepare the food for Lord Krishna?
Well,
Because she said, she further said that because if we prepare the sweets, it's always put too much sugar and oil.
Well, you don't have to put so much sugar and oil.
首先呢，就是在做甜品的时候呢，不需要放太多糖和油。
You can put less sugar and oil.
所以呢，你在做饭的时候呢，你可以少放点糖，少放点油。
And remember, when you're cooking, you don't just cook for yourself. You can distribute to other people.
还有呢，就是你要记得，就是当您在做饭的时候呢，其实您并不是只给自己在做饭，您可以把您做好的这个食物派给其他的人。
Yes.
Next one.
Yeah.
Shruti Rupa's comments. Hare Krishna, 感恩 Guru. 今天我第一次从户外摘了野花回来供奉神像，谢谢 Guru 的鼓励。So, first, then Gati Prada Mataji.哦，普布，顶拜咕噜队和所有的奉献者，如果供奉 Krishna 喜欢的，而家里人并不爱吃，然后为了让家里人吃上 prasada 迎合家人的口味供奉，这是妨碍服务吗？ Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. If I offer the food, which is favorite to Lord Krishna, but it's not a favorite to my family members. However, in order to have my family members to take prasada, so I just try to cook something.With a favorite of their taste. Is this considered as a devotional service?
Yes.
算妨碍服务。
Yeah, when I was saying that we cook for Krishna, that's particularly I'm talking about the deity and the temple.
就是刚才我说的就是我们要做 Krishna 喜欢的这个食物，其实我特别讲的是为在庙里的神像做供奉。
What you do in your own home, that's more flexible.
那当你在家里面在做事情的时候呢，要更有这个灵活性。
And you're cooking for yourself. You can't cook so many things. You can't make so many things.
而且呢，就是如果要是只为自己做饭的话呢，肯定就不能做的样太多。
Yeah, we won't be cooking sweets all the time.
那我们也不可能一直都在做甜品。
But in temples, where you have a proper temple and you've established a deity, then there's standards for worship.
但是呢，如果我们要是有庙的话，而且有这个安放的神像的话，那么就会要确立一个崇拜的标准。
Just like here in Mayapur, they have special cooks who just make sweets for the deities every day.
那么就好像在 Mayapur, 那我们这儿呢就有专门的甜品师傅，天天为神像做甜品。
And they have, you know, the good quantity of fresh milk. They get this fresh milk from the cows and they use that to make the milk sweets.
而且呢，他们还会专门从乳牛那儿打来这个很多的鲜牛奶，然后用这个鲜牛奶为神像做甜品。
So we do this in the established temples, but you can't expect to do that in your home.
对，所以说呢，我们是在这个已经建起的庙里面去做这些事情，但是我们不能够巴望着在家里面也做同样的事情。
嗯、
Yes, the next one, from Taruni Tusi Mataji, 顶拜咕噜做 prasadam 和供奉时怀着怎样的知觉最恰当、最能取悦 Krishna 呢？ Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances while we are preparing prasadam.And while we offer this food to the Lord, what kind of consciousness we should take, we should hold in that way to please Krishna the most?
Well, the consciousness should be that I am the servant of Krishna, and I'm offering, I'm preparing this, I've prepared the food for Krishna, I'm offering it to him. And we ask him, please kindly consider accepting this food.
那最好的这种知觉呢，就是我，承认我是Sri Krishna的仆人的这样的心态，然后呢，我是为他在做这个供奉，然后恳请他能够接受这个供奉。
The mood of being a humble servant, that's the main thing.
最主要的事情呢，就是让自己处于一个谦卑的仆人的心境之下。 Okay, Radisha's question. She's asking if the spice is Ave.
Ave.
How to say that in English?
That's a king, isn't it?
King. Yes. She's asking if it's okay to offer the king to the deity.
Yes.
可以,
yeah, we offer hing. Hing is a substitute for onion. We don't use onion, but if you use hing, that's a very good, that gives a nice, the flavor, which is something similar to onions.
因为这个阿魏啊，它其实是蒜，大蒜的代替品，就是我们因为不用大蒜，那但你要是在这个食物里面要放上阿魏的话呢，它就能够给这个食物调很好的味道。 然后下面这个问题哈，就是顶拜咕噜，请问艾卡达西日为何不能吃蜂蜜？在哪里有明确的关于艾卡达西日饮食列表？还有四月苦行在哪里经典里可以找到答案？This Mataji, she is asking, she paid her humble obeisances to you, and she asked why in the day of Ekadasi we are not able to take the honey, and also from where we can specifically to find what to eat for the Ekadasi days, and also through which sastra we can find the to find how to observe the Chaturdasi.
Okay, so first of all, honey, I have never heard that you cannot take honey on Ekadasi.
Yes, 那首先呢，我从来没有听说过在艾卡达西不能吃蜂蜜。
The vegans, they don't take honey.
那些就是这个蛋奶素者，他们是完全彻底的素食者，他们是不吃蜂蜜的。
Vegan has become quite popular around the world. A lot of people have taken to the vegan diet.
因为这个蛋奶素者现在已经在世界上变得越来越普遍，那么很多人他们就是会以这样的素食习惯的。
So they don't take honey because it's coming from the bees, and they say it's the property of the bees, it's not for us.
那么他们之所以不吃蜂蜜的原因呢，是因为他们说这个蜂蜜是来自于蜜蜂的，所以说呢，这是蜜蜂的财产，我们不应该吃。
But honey was a great favorite of Lord Balaram.
但是呢，主 Balaram 可喜欢吃蜜蜂蜜了。
And so I've never heard that on Ekadasi we couldn't take honey. I don't know where you got this from.
Yeah, 所以说呢，因为我从来没听说过艾卡达西不能够吃蜂蜜，所以我也不知道你是从哪听来的。
There are some spices which they don't encourage us to use on Ekadasi because sometimes they mix some kinds of grains in them.
那么就有一些这个佐料，我们是不建议在艾卡达西的时候用的，因为这些佐料里面呢，可能是混杂了一些谷物在里面。It's
very difficult to get things which are pure in this Kali Yuga.
但是呢，在卡利年代很难找到非常纯的东西了。We
got some semolina one time. You know semolina? Simi.
Yes.
So we got some semolina, and it was coated in some grains, you know.
我们有一次呢，就弄到了一些西米。这西米本来艾卡达西是可以吃的，但是呢，西米它外面就被包了一些谷物。
And similarly, often you buy milk powder, and you want to use it on a karasi, and then you look on the packet and you see they've got some grains in the milk powder.
Yeah, 而且还有的时候呢，就比如说像奶粉，那本来奶粉我们是想给艾卡达西用的，但是你看那个食物表里面就发现它里面也是掺了一些谷物在里面。
So, it's very difficult to know what you can take on a karasi.
所以说呢，就是，你到底能够在艾卡达西时候就是能够吃什么？其实这也挺难做到的。
So be careful.
Now
Chaturmasya, where can we find out what to eat? The Prabhupada simply said Chaturmasya, the first month, no leafy, green leafy vegetables, or no sak, right? No sak.
No sak. No sak means green vegetable, right?
Botai.
菠菜，菠菜，菠菜，菠菜 ，OK，spinach。那个就是说爸爸就关于艾克达，就是四月苦行的这个不能吃什么？说爸爸就简单说，第一个月就不能吃绿叶菜，其实就不能吃菠菜。
The first month, 不能吃菠菜。And the second month, don't take yogurt.
那第二个月呢，不要喝酸奶。
And the third month, milk.
第三个月呢是牛奶。
And then the fourth month.We should not take the earth dal or high protein food.
然后呢，在第三个月的时候呢，就不能吃一些就是有着高蛋白含量的豆类。
That means things like, like soya.
就像黄豆啊 ，chibi.
I don't know that. What's that? Chickpeas, very high protein. The idea is you shouldn't take any non-vegetarian food in the fourth month.
Non-vegetarian food.
Meat. In other words, you shouldn't take meat in the fourth month.
Oh, okay. So this is actually for non-devotees, right?
Well, yeah, for everybody, right? Yeah. So,
okay. 就我刚才有点晕了，因为刚才马尔说，就第四个月呢是不能够吃素食之外的食物，也就是说在第四个月的时候不能吃肉。就任何一个人在这，如果是要守这四月苦行，在第四个月的时候不要吃肉。
So we try to get people who are not devotees, try to get them to follow.
那所以说呢，就是让那些不是奉献者的人，如果让他们能够去守这四月苦行的话呢，看看能不能行。
But some of the dal, some types of dal are very high protein, and they shouldn't be taken.
而且有时候就是这个豆汤啊，就这个豆类，它是有很高的，就这个去皮绿豆，它有很高的。蛋白质，所以呢是不能吃的。
So in India, people are they have to eat dal every meal. You know, they have dal. With the lunch is very necessary to have dal.
Yeah. 但你知道，在印度的时候呢，就是豆汤是他们必须喝的，每顿午餐是一定要喝豆汤的。
But in the month of Kartik, they should not take the high protein dal.
但是呢，就是在卡蒂克月的时候，就不要吃最就是这个有着高蛋白质含量的豆汤。
And people in South India, they're very
In
South India, people are accustomed to eat idli and dosa, which is made with earth dal.
Okay, 然后呢，在这个。这样的这个食物，那这个就是由波尔岛，就是由这个高蛋白的这个豆类做成的，芸豆做成的。
So it's a problem for them in the fourth month.
所以说这第四个月对于南印度的人来说就有点难。
But a little austerity is good for us.
但是如果我们要是去遵守一些苦行呢，是好的。
And we see sometimes some of the sannyas, some people will do things like during the 4 months of Chaturmasya, they won't shave, they won't cut their hair, they won't cut their nails.
然后呢，我们还会看到有些人，他们在四月苦行的时候呢，他们就不会剃头，他们也不会这个剃胡子，然后呢，也不会长指甲。
And they will reduce their eating, maybe only take one meal a day.
然后呢，他们还会减少进食的量，也许可能就是一天就吃一顿饭。
And they will increase their chanting.
然后呢，他们会加多他们的念诵。
Chanting maybe 64 rounds every day.
每天可能都会念诵64圈。
So like that, they do like that to observe Chaturmasya.
他们就是这样来去遵守Chaturmasya四月苦行。
Okay.
Yeah, Marge, actually there were two more questions. May I ask to hold it for an afternoon section? Because right now it's almost 2 o'clock.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's a good idea. Let's hope you can give them to, who's in the afternoon? Is it?
Me.
You're coming again in the afternoon?
Yeah, I'm very fortunate today.
Oh, I'm very fortunate today. Okay. Thank you very much. So I'll see you in the afternoon.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
So, Maharaj, please allow me to explain the situation to the devotees. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的奉献者们，因为我们后面还有一些问题，然后呢，因为现在都差不多也快2点了，我们就把这个问题呢，就先挪到下午再请顾问解答。
Okay. Hare Krishna. Shao Jian. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai. So, Hare Krishna.